Well, it's the conclusion of a big story, so they can expect a big battle. Mary, not so much. Mary's not really a war type. She's not into guns. So for Mary, I think she goes on quite a different journey to everybody. It's a very different colour to the whole story, which is quite nice. You know, you go from these big battle scenes to Mary in a much quieter but equally important sort of discovery. Well, she's quite an unlikely hero. You know, she's in her office doing her quantum physics, and the fact that she's sort of been chosen, or this prophecy has singled her out to play such a big part in this, you know, massive high-stakes story, I think that's what's quite interesting about her. She doesn't go seeking out this journey. It comes and finds her, and then she has to be quite resourceful, and she has to be quite brave, and go from what's a very real world into this very crazy, you know, and meet all these crazy characters.
Can you talk a bit about the production experience on this most beautiful and exotic final chapter?
Well, we've got the most incredible team working on it, and they're all very, very passionate about the story. We've got Joel, who has made, I mean, the work that he's done, and you'll see this particular set that he created, which is the tree, the home tree, and it was so stunning. I mean, what they made, everybody loved it. There was birds trying to nest in it, like real birds coming in Cardiff, and then, you know, Russell and Framestore, the work that they do on creating the demons. I mean, it's just, it's all the best of the best, like the best team of people. And we're just really lucky to have such a great team of people coming together.
Of all the fantasy worlds, what do you think is unique about the one that Philip's given us? And why do you think this story, these characters, mean so very much to so many people?
I think it's a big fantasy drama, but I think, and when they first came on the shelves, they were in the children's section, which I don't think Philip had written them specifically for children. But actually, adults get a whole lot from them as well, because for the children, it's got, like, you know, the demons and all of these great creatures. But there's a lot of big questions in there about, you know, spirituality versus science, and religion versus atheism, and all these big theological questions, and I think that for me, when I read them years ago, I hadn't read anything like that before that really touched me, you know. I think in this season, towards the end of the season, we get to hear a little bit more about Mary's backstory, and that was really, you know, when I read the books, and I loved how they took that from book to script. I think they did a wonderful job on it. Francesca Gardner, I think, worked quite hard on that episode 8. She's a wonderful writer. And all of that stuff that we filmed, where we see a little bit more about her backstory, is really lovely.
Do you have a final message to fans, people who adore these books, have adored this series, and cannot wait for one last journey with you all?
I just hope you really enjoy it, and that you get as much from watching it as we got from making it.